Hello students, welcome back to maths class. In this video we will see the representation of numbers on the number line. Okay, this topic we are especially going with the rational number. So before rational number we will see the natural number. Representation of numbers on the number line in this topic. Firstly we will go through the natural number. So for putting the numbers on the number line, you can simply see I drawn one line, and on this line I parted some points. Okay, with the help of scale I drawn this line. Okay, you can use anything straight material. If you don't have a scale on that time, simply you can see the gap between each part, it will be same. Okay, when you are drawing the number line on that time, the gap between each gap, okay, the gap between each part is must be same. Okay, so try to put it with the help of scale, because in the scale we have centimeters. Okay, so you can put half centimeter, 1 centimeter, 2 centimeter according to need. Okay, according to need we can put any kind of gap with the help of scale. So firstly we will go with the natural number, and we know natural numbers begin with 1. Okay, begin with 1. So the first number which will comes on the number line will be 1. After 1 we completed first gap, so 1 plus first gap 2, 2 plus next gap 3, then 4, then 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. You can simply see after 12 I drawn arrow. It means that our line is not stopped here. According to our need we can increase or decrease the length of number line. Okay, but you have to begin natural number line with the 1, because the natural numbers begin with 1. Then whole numbers. Whole numbers is the set of 0 and natural number. It means that our whole number will begin with 0. Okay, and same as natural number we will follow the method. Firstly we will draw the line, and we will part it, the each gap. And the distance between each gap is must be same. So it will begin with 0. After that 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. And once again here we have arrow. It means that our number line is not stopped here. It begin with 0 and it will go continuously. Now for the integer. Integers are the set of zeros, positive number and negative number. What I said, integers are the set of 0, positive number and negative number. It means that in between the set of integer we have 0. So here in the middle I am putting here 0. On the right hand side we have all positive numbers. So firstly we will complete the positive number series, which is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Once again here we have comma, here we have arrow, which is showing us our line can be increased or decreased according to need. Okay, now when we will go on the left hand side of 0, on that time we have negative integers, which is minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, minus 4, minus 5, minus 6, minus 7, minus 8, and once again here we have arrow, which is showing us that in this direction our line, number line can be increased or decreased. So in the set of integers our number line can be increased or decreased in both direction, in the right as well as in the left. But in the whole number set, it is only increase or decrease in the right hand side because it is begun with natural number begun with 1 and whole number begun with 0. But integers is not begun with anywhere or not ending anywhere. It is the set of 0, positive numbers and negative numbers. So here we have both and is containing arrows. Now the next topic is rational numbers. Now we will show rational numbers on the number line. Okay. So firstly, we can take one small example. Okay. For 1 by 4. Okay. Is it the rational number? Rational number said it can be represented in the form of P upon Q, where P and Q are integers. Simply you can see our 1 and 4 are integers, positive integers, and the value of Q will not be equal to 0. Have you seen our denominator is 4? Okay, so yes, it is a rational number kyunki iska denominator, its denominator is not a 0. Okay, now we will draw a number line for this rational number. So firstly I will draw a number line, then I will part the same part. Okay, I will give the same gap between each and every part, as you can see. So here is our number line which is containing both and arrow, and you can simply see the gap between each part is same, which I drawn with the use of scale. Okay, so we have to represent this rational number 1 upon 4 on this number line. So before putting 1 upon 4, firstly you can once again revise. Rational number is in the form of P upon Q, where P and Q both are integers. It means as our integers number line drawn, same we will follow the pattern here. It means that in between, okay, we have to show the 0 with negative and positive integers. So you can simply see our rational number 1 upon 4 is positive. It means that we need more number in positive side. Our rational number is positive. It means that we need more number in positive. That's why we are shuffling 0 just little bit left, because we need positive rational number more. Okay. And negative number we will show only 2. Okay. So our rational number is 1 upon 4. As we are putting the integers number line, same we will put here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. You can simply see in the denominator of the rational number is 4. So we will simply put denominator of each number as 4. Okay, so here we have positive side. Same we will do in the negative side, which is negative 1 upon 4, negative 2 upon 4. Have you identified where is our positive one? Yes, 4 upon 4 is giving us positive 1, and 8 upon 4 is giving us positive 2. Okay, and have you seen our 1 upon 4? Yes, this point which is just nearby, just right of 0, which is showing as A, this A we can put ourselves, our A point is showing 1 upon 4. So simply we will write point A represent 1 upon 4. Okay. One more example we can see, which can be negative 3 upon 5. Okay. Negative 3 upon 5. For this we will draw number line. As you can see, firstly we will draw a number line, then we will part them. So here we have line which is containing the gap of, which is containing the part with same distance. You can simply see our rational number, which is minus 3 upon 5, is negative. So we needed more numbers in the negative side. Now we will shuffle our 0 just little bit in the right hand side. Okay. Now we will simply put our positive side, which is 1, 2. In the negative side, same as it is, minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, minus 4, minus 5, minus 6, minus 7, minus 8, minus 9, minus 10, and minus 11. Now we want its denominator is 5, so we will put the denominator of each one as 5. Okay? As here, here, everywhere we will put denominator as 5. Now, you can simply see, we need minus 3 upon 5. So, where is minus 3 upon 5? Yes, on point B, we have minus 3 upon 5. So, simply we will write point B represents minus 3 upon 5. Okay. Have you find out minus 1? Yes. Our minus 5 upon 5 is representing minus 1. Minus 10 upon 5 is representing minus 2. Okay. So, here we have the number line for the minus 3 upon 5. Now, the last example that we will see for the 1, 3 upon 2. It means that we have mixed fraction. So firstly, we will solve this mixed fraction into improper fraction. So 2 will multiply in the 1, which is 2, 1 is 2. Then answer will add into 3. Answer is 2, 2 plus 3 is 5 upon 2. Okay, it means that we need to show 5 upon 2. Okay. So, 5 upon 2 is the positive number. It means we needed more number in the positive side. So, we will put 0 just little bit in the left hand side. So, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 in the right side of 0. And in the left side of 0, we have minus 1, minus 2, minus 3 and minus 4. We want our denominator as 2, so we will put 2 in the denominator of positive and in the negative integers, as you can see. Here we have. So our 5 by 2, you can simply see 1 upon 2, 2 upon 2, which is showing 1. 3 upon 2, 4 upon 2, which is showing 2. 5 upon 2, yes. So this point we will show through the C. So point C is representing our 5 upon 2. 6 upon 2 is 3, 7 upon 2, 8 upon 2 is 4. This side, minus 2 upon 2 is minus 2, minus 4 upon minus 1, minus 4 upon 2 is minus 2. So we have to represent 5 upon 2 on the number line. So point C, okay, point C represents 5 upon 2 or 1, 3 upon 2. So here we have the number line of natural system, whole number, integers and rational number. Okay. Now we will begin our exercise 1.2 for class 8. Its first question is represent these numbers on the number line. Its first one, 7 upon 4. 7 upon 4 is the positive rational number. It means that we needed more positive number. We needed more positive numbers. For that, we will shuffle just our 0 just in the left hand side, just a little bit. Okay. So, in the right hand side, we have positive numbers, which is 1, 2, 3, 4, up to so on. And in the left hand side, we have negative. Okay. We want as the denominator of a rational number is 4. So, all over we will put the denominator of each number as a 4 as you can see. So here we have 0 and this side we have positive numbers and this side we have negative numbers. So 7 upon 4 is here, which we can see using O. Okay. So before 7 upon 4 we have 4 upon 4, which is showing 1. 8 upon 4 is showing 3. Okay. 2. 8 upon 4 is showing 2. Okay, when we reduce 8 by 4, on that time we will get 2. Okay. After 11 upon 4 we have 12 upon 4, which is showing 3. Okay, which is showing 3. So here we will write point O represent 7 upon 4. For the second part, which is minus 5 upon 6, we will draw a line and we will part them with equal gap. Okay. So we have minus 5 upon 6. It is a negative integer. It is a negative number, negative rational number, and it has negative symbol. That's why we needed more negative numbers. For that, we will shift our 0 just little bit off in the right hand side. Okay. This side we have 1, 2, 3, 4 in the right hand side. And in the left hand side we have negative numbers, which is minus 2, minus 3, minus 4, minus 5, minus 6, minus 7, minus 8, minus 9. Now we will put the denominator as 6. Okay, all over the numbers will have the denominator of 6. Okay, have you identified where is our minus 5 upon 6? Okay, yes, on the left side of 0 we have minus 5 upon 6, which we are representing through P. Okay, so point P is representing minus 5 upon 6, and just in the left hand side of minus 5 upon 6 we have minus 6 upon 6, which is representing minus 1. Okay, so we will simply write here point P represents minus 5 upon 6. Same we will do second part. Second question is represent minus 2 upon 11, minus 5 upon 11, minus 9 upon 11 on the number line. Okay. Okay. You can simply see 11, 11, 11. All three numbers are containing denominator of 11. So we can represent all three numbers in the one line. All three numbers in a single line. If they are containing the different denominator, on that time we need to draw different number line for each one. But here in this case all three numbers are containing same denominator. It means in the one number line we can represent all three numbers. As you can see, as I draw on a line, okay, all three are negative. It means that we needed more numbers in the negative side. For representing them, I'm shuffling just a little bit in the left, in the right hand side is 0. Okay, so here we have right hand side is 1, 2, 3, 4, positive integers. But in the left hand side we have all the negative integers, which will we have minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, minus 4, so on here. And all our three numbers are containing denominator of 11, so we will put all over the number lines denominator as 11. As here we have to identify minus 2 upon 3. Okay. So minus 2 upon 3 is just left hand side of 0, minus 1 upon 11, minus 2 upon 3. So here is our minus 2 upon 3, which we will name as A. Okay. We will put the name of the number on the number line. Now minus 5 upon 11, when we are traveling from minus 2 upon 11, in the left hand side we will get minus 5 upon 11, which we are naming as B. And just little bit left hand side we have minus 9 upon 11, which is representing C. And thoda sa, and when we are going just little bit left hand side of minus 9 upon 11, we will get minus 11 upon 11, which is representing minus 1. Okay, so point A, our point A is representing minus 2 upon 11, B representing minus 5 upon 11, and C is representing minus 9 upon 11. So here we completed two questions of exercise 1.2. The remaining questions we will see in the next class. In this video, if you found any kind of difficulty, please comment. Do comment, I will try to solve.